Midday product battery charger. And this thing has spent a little too much time out in the rain, and it tends to trip its internal thermal fuse. So I went on Amazon and found this. The condition of my purchase was that it was in a not a potted unit, because I wanted to know if it was going to be a fire hazard by opening it. Let's look at the outside. It's a Foxer. Oh, this one has English and Cyrillic, which is really handy. What does that say? I don't know. Charapaka? Karandash. Yani Biazavut Paruski is what that says. Canada! USA! I like that the box gives me the option of it being yellow or orange. I guess I got orange. Alright, so what's going on here? We got a fan that I literally don't know where it was. What looks like some kind of switch mode power supply. And a little controller. Of course, the identifying markings are removed from the IC, the country that's world renowned for stealing ideas, doesn't want people stealing their ideas. Takes one to know one, I guess. The fan sits at, which end? Oh no. I have to go that way. So the fan sits at this end. So the heat sinks are kind of oriented a bit stupidly for a fan, but because it's blowing on the sides of them. It's actually nicely constructed. There aren't terrible solder joints. Everything looks nicely finished. Fairly good isolation. It's hard to keep this stable. Definitely a couple janky looking solder joints on this capacitor here. Both of them look like it's just stuck on. So those are gonna get redone. That lead there, that one there, is kind of poorly trimmed. So yeah, you can really see the bad joint there. That's gonna get fixed. Cleaned up nicely. Can't get any closer. Zoom. I don't think it's a lead-free solder. These are soldering very nicely. I just realized this is the high-voltage side of the board. So I'm going to take care of some of these excessively long. I don't like the way that one looks. All right, I'm going to trim off some of these leads. Trimmed a few leads. I'm feeling better about that. The other thing I checked was how the battery clips are assembled, and good thing they put those little strain relief doodads on there to hold the jacket. They didn't even bother to close them, so I'm going to do that. Much better. So this is a bit lame. 2 × 0.5 mm². That's the equivalent of 20 AWG, which is... I don't like it. Normally in North American produced, or stuff produced for the North American market, 16 AWG is kind of the smallest, sometimes 18, but 20. And I wouldn't be surprised if it was that aluminum, copper-covered aluminum crap. So, that's going to need to be replaced, but I don't know how I'm going to do that. And because it's got this nice little grommety thing here, which I'll just have to... do something different, I guess. But okay, so that's a bit janky. Let's plug it in. There you go, so you can see what's going on. Hang on. Yeah, and this feels, I again wouldn't be surprised if this was copper coated aluminum for these wires. These are a bit heavier gauge. 5 amps at 12 volts, they're probably okay. And this is probably okay too. But, you know, you think about as it wears with use and strands start to break, there's a lot less life in a 20 AWG conductor. That's like telephone wire. Like this stuff right here is, that's 24. And that's, so it's not much bigger than that. Yeah, no thanks. All right. Make sure these aren't touching each other. And plug it in. Plug it in. Hmm. Well, let's double check that. 11 degrees Celsius? Is that what it thinks the temperature is right now? It is humid as heck in here. And it is 23 degrees. So I don't think that's working. Battery. Red to red. Mm-hmm. Black to black. Ooh, little fan's giving her 2.2 amps. Figures it's 100% charged. Chatterpaka says blinky blink. Temperature is for reference only. Allowed tolerance. Is 23 and it's reading at 13 is 10 degrees Celsius tolerance. I guess. So the reason it measures temperature is because it has summer. Winter, there's different output voltages depending on whether it's summer or winter temperature. If it's cold, which, all right, it's never going to be that cold, it'll be chilly, but the manual is surprisingly comprehensible. Maybe not. Stop to charge when the battery is heating. Check the battery is in shortage of liquid or not. Please charge cycle 1 to 2 times. Unable to reach full status after charging in long time, the battery has been vulcanized. Or feeder or water depletion in the battery. Okay, I take back what I said. Alright, well, I don't know. To be here. That fan's going, but I can... You can barely feel airflow. I guess it's enough to keep those heat sinks from heating up. I'll let you know in a little while if this explodes. It says it's full. This battery's from December 1st, 2011. It's only 9 years old. I don't think it's full. 12 point, yeah. What happens if I push repair? It is a 9 year old battery. What's that? What is that? Let's move this. Oh, that's just switching transients. I don't know. So this repair mode is definitely causing the battery to outgas. I mean, I knew they were crap, but don't need to be even crappier. Convenient length cord.
High quality.
See, it's unplugged now because it made a weird noise, which means the battery was venting. So I guess repair mode's good if you want to make your batteries vent. I think it's the batteries. It's just this the end of its days. I don't know why they have a button that apparently just makes it vent. I don't know. I'm just going to let it sit there for a while.
So it's been a while since I recorded the first section of this video. How long is a while?
Well, here's the outside temperature right now.
So it's been a while. I've been using this quite a bit, this charger. I've been using it to charge those batteries down there, my 35 amp hour AGM batteries, and it seems to work fine. They're not exploding or do anything weird or bubbling. And I've also used it to charge a big 12 volt deep cycle battery that I've been using to I've been using those to power these GPS receivers. And it seems to be a good charger. It hasn't smelled like burning things, and it works. So, is that? It looks like it's got, like, that film you peel off. I noticed this when I was editing the video. I might just be making a mess of it. Oh, no. Oh, yeah. Come on. Oh, yeah. Okay, well, that concludes this video. See you on the next one.